So most of the stuff I want to talk about has been talked about in Lakshman stuff. Alright. So I'll cover the differences. Okay. So that it is not a waste of time. I was playing with the Crossfilter. Crossfilter is a filtering library for JavaScript. I'll quickly do the introduction. Now, what Crossfilter does is, I guess, so I've been a developer for the last few years, and currently I am running a personal finance startup in Bangalore. Earlier I did a startup in tax filing space called Clear Tax. Now, why I got into it? So, I was playing with Crossfilter. I got fascinated with the whole, interactive filtering thing. And at the same time, I learned about Angular. And I was curious that, can we merge these two? Can we have, Crossfilter work in Angular framework? Okay. But I lost the motivation. So what I did was I submitted a proposal at MetaRefresh that if I get selected, then I'll probably, finish this up. Yeah. It's called conference level development. Yeah, I think I got shortlisted. It's 5-4 votes. 2 were like from me and my mate. And, I got a call 6 days before that, your talk is selected, now come present. So I had 6 days to get this work. Okay, why Crossfilter? It's interactive filtering. Okay, again, very quick show you. You can see that the data below is changing and the data above is also changing. What this means is that the data model behind all these plots are connected. It's the same model. Because that's why when you change data in one of the plots, everything gets affected. Alright. It's a similar analogy to database indices. Where you build the index, you create an index, then you can do range queries. So what this library does is it brings the whole database index concept to front end. Right, you can do all those kind of queries just at the plot. Now, as we talked about, right, that AngularJS has its own data binding, and how would you marry these two? Okay. Now, well, plotting is a DOM manipulation, alright. So, in order to do a plot, you have to write directives for it. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take the same piece of code and show you how it was earlier in jQuery land and now how it is different in the AngularJS land, alright. So, this is the JavaScript code of the. Let me show you another example. Alright, so what this does is this is a data about venture capital investment in different states, in different industries. Right? And what you can do is you can select a particular state, a particular industry, and the whole data moves accordingly. Now, the way it was done in jQuery land is that you read the data, you run the Crossfilter on top of it, you create dimensions. Dimensions are nothing but indices on which you can run the range queries, right? And then once, so this is basically like setting up a state. You read the data, you set the state, right? And all the graphs share the same state. So that, you know, when you change the data, the state changes and all graphs get updated by that. Okay. And, you know, once the data is read, the state is set, it creates the plots, which is the DOM manipulation. So, okay, now the challenge I had was that I wanted to create directives for each of the plots and I wanted them to share data. I wanted them to share the state so that if one directive, I change any range of data, it changes for everything. And that's how they will stay connected. I mean, that's how Crossfilter works. That's how, because they create this, you know, data model, which all the plots share and indexes are created, and then you can change the value of plot in one of the plot, change the value in one of the plots, and everything gets reflected, right? So, how do we do that? Well, in Angular, there is something called services, which Lakshman introduced, or factory. Okay. Now, factory are singletons. So what it means is that you can create an instance, or sorry, you can declare a factory, you can create your state in the factory, and you can pass this state in all your directives. And once, since all the directives will share the state, now when you, you know, change the data, so it's like this, the two-step process of creating the state and doing the DOM manipulation is moved into creating a factory for creating the state, and each of the DOM manipulation is done in each of the directives. I'll just come to it. Okay. So, okay. Now, let me just show the HTML. Now, this is what we do for, you know, creating directives. I declare two directives, US chart, industry chart, okay, for declaring the states, and industry is, you know, the bubble chart. And so what happens inside US chart? We pass the factory, okay, which contains the state, right? We declare that the common, you know, definition and element type. We declare an isolated scope. And this is the, this is where the all action happens, link, right? I mean, and link has access to the factory. So we watch till, I come to this, you know, watch part in a bit. So what it does is it has access to the CF and it reads the state from it to create the dimensions and to create the plot. And it happens similarly in the industry chart. Okay. This is the industry directive and it has access to the factory as well. So, look at this, it reads the state which has been created in the factory. Right. Now, there's one more thing actually, there's an async part where, now let's look at the control flow, how does the flow of the control, flow happens. Okay. Now, we declare a controller. And controller also has access to the factory. Okay. This calls the setup method. Now, what is setup is one of the methods which has been exposed in the factory. So, factory exposes the setup method, which is to create the set of the state. And there are other bunch of methods which are to access the different values of the state. So what setup does is, it reads the file, creates the state, okay? And once it is done reading all the files, it calls the digest. What digest calls is, it re-renders the plot, okay? It, and within the directive, within the you know, the US chart and the industry chart which we are trying to plot here. Alright. So within these charts, it watches for the variable val. Okay. This val comes from here in the HTML. Now, once this val gets populated within the setup method, it calls the digest and the control comes here. It says, it sees that the val has changed and it renders the plot. So that's how the asynchronous part of the code is, you know, taken care of. And this is what it is done using Angular. Okay. So it works. So I guess to sum this up, you know, I would say that, you know, all the things we learned from, you know, Lakshman's talk, the differences were that this is a data sharing concept which I had to deal with while I was doing this, and factories being singletons came to rescue. Okay. The asynchronous nature, for that we use the digest and the watch. Okay. So watch, you can use any variable, when it changes it replots the whole graph. There is scoping, so you can use the scoping to, scoping is little data binding, okay, so once you want the variable you are watching to be available, to be visible, so for that you take the isolated scope for that variable. So it worked, and you know, it worked in the last couple of days. So I was fine that, yeah, I can present this. Okay. Some references, like Crossfilter, you can look at GitHub, or the DC, you can look at. DC is a derivative of Crossfilter, which builds or adds meta charts on top of it. What else? AngularD3, so is AngularD3, this third reference which talks about, you know, how to write, how to build D3 plots or SVG plots using Angular. So that's where he shows how to make directives to build SVG plots. Okay. And fourth one is a good tutorial reference for Angular. Yeah, that's cool. Any questions? Alright. I guess it was a subset of the earlier talk.
Sorry. It's a campfire moment. Notification.
Blast. Alright.